Good afternoon. I'm Paul Denning. Welcome to Super Return Asia Hong Kong. It gives me great pleasure today to introduce Ken Siegel. He's the best-selling author of the book Insanely Simple, The Obsession That Drives Apple's Success. Ken worked with Steve Jobs at Apple for over 12 years, was the creative director, and just by the way, just our luncheon speaker here at Super Return Asia. He tries to keep the message simple, and that's his message to his clients and to the world and to us today. And one of the things, Ken, that you came across and to us today, it said the simplicity never fails. Being simple isn't simple. And I just wondered, as you get into this, is pretty heady stuff, how do you guide clients through the complexities that they have to arrive at these simple solutions?
Well, I think the great thing about simplicity is that everyone wants it. It's not really a tough sell. So when I go in to meet with a new client, I think they pretty much buy from the beginning that we want the message to be simple. And then you can sort of slowly expose them to what they're doing wrong and how their message isn't simple. And you start bringing new ideas to them and show how even a complicated proposition can be presented in a simpler, more easy to appreciate manner.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was wondering, too, in as you were talking to the audience there, you mentioned that Steve Jobs not only wanted people to, he wanted people to love the Apple products, that he didn't want them to just like it. He wanted them to love the products. They had to be palpable. And I think all of us that have been in business or sales understand that and understand the feeling, but we don't understand very well how to get people to arrive at that, have that belief and that trust in that product or the idea. How did you and he work that out to get to that level?
Well, I had it good in that Apple's products embodied simplicity, and people would fall in love with Apple products. So, you know, it helps when your client has a product like that. But for other clients making other kinds of products, I think having them understand that you need to create this emotional bond with a customer for a variety of reasons, it makes them resistant to going elsewhere. People get attached to you and they keep buying more stuff from you and they talk to their friends and their family and their colleagues. That's kind of what Steve wanted to build. He wanted to, at every level, you know, whether it's the commercial they saw on television or the experience of opening the box or when they had a problem with a product, that when they brought it back to Apple, how understanding Apple was, that everything was supposed to make them love Apple more. And I think the results are pretty obvious, that Apple has probably the greatest brand loyalty of any brand on earth, and people, the Apple customers truly love their relationship with Apple, and they're willing to forgive Apple when they make a mistake once in a while because they're Apple and they're human, and you know, we associate with their values, we share their values.
Well, how did, and you mentioned during your talk too that it was one ad or one message that Apple wasn't there to make money, they were there to create, produce great products. Go into that a little bit more.
Yeah, it's one of those things that I get a lot of raised eyebrows when I say that, because a lot of people think Apple is only there to make money, but it's really true, I think, that Apple's priorities are a bit different than a lot of companies. Apple, you know, the quote I used was from Johnny Ive, and the first part of his quote, that Apple's goal isn't to make money, and then he goes on to explain, the goal is to make great products, and if you do that well, then you make money. Whereas other companies I've worked with, for the most part, it's pretty obvious they're there to make money. There aren't people up there giving speeches about how we're going to change the world with this and it's going to change lives forever. It's more like, we need 10% more clicks this quarter than we had last quarter. And by the way, do some ads, you know.
Yeah.
So I think Apple is special in that way, that they, you know, the goal of the company really is to finesse the products, distill them to their essence, make them super capable and simple, and that if they do that well, people will keep coming back for more. And that's why I think they become so successful.
And I guess in last, what's sort of the simple lesson that you learned, and you know, you and I have been around, whatever businesses were around for a long time, that you saw Steve Jobs, someone of his intellectual capacity, his brain power, go through some very difficult moments. You saw him stumble and fail and come back and then become very successful again. What drove him? How did he do that?
I think Steve had in him this desire to do the right thing. And I know that sounds kind of trite, but it was both in a moral sense and in a product sense. And I think there were some issues that came up along the way where there were moral issues about, you know, what kind of apps they make available in the Apple Store, or some ad ran in some part of the world and it offended some community's beliefs for whatever reason. He didn't just sort of pander to, you know, how are we going to get out of this kind of thing. He truly wanted to do the right thing. And in a product sense, he wanted to create that love, and therefore he wanted the experience to be first class at every point. So there were discussions about the quality of the materials that would go even into making an ad, like when you saw it in a magazine, the kind of paper it would be printed on. He wanted that experience, every bit of it, to be a high quality, so that people got the feeling from Apple that they really created a quality product, and they would get more attached to them for that. So I think Steve's thing was doing the right thing, and the right thing for him was whatever it was, whatever it would take to make, you know, a customer happier. It was all about the customer experience, and he never wavered from that. I think that's what drove him. How do I create the best possible customer experience?
Yeah. Interesting. Good. Thank you very much. It's been my pleasure.
My pleasure.